Welcome to the Center for Tobacco Products webinar on how to request language assistance for retailers who have received a tobacco civil money penalty or no tobacco sale order complaint. This presentation will cover three topics. First, we'll discuss the options available to retailers after receiving either a civil money penalty, also known as a CMP, or a no tobacco sale order, also known as an NTSO complaint. Second, we will discuss the language assistance services that the Center for Tobacco Products, or CTP, provides to retailers. And finally, we will go over instructions for how a retailer can request an interpreter. CTP conducts inspections of tobacco retail establishments to ensure compliance with the Family Smoking Prevention and Tobacco Control Act and its implementing regulations. If retailers are not in compliance, CTP will generally issue a warning letter, CMP, or NTSO complaint against the retailer. Violations may include, but are not limited to, a retailer or the retailer's employee selling tobacco products to someone under the age of 21 or selling single cigarettes. A warning letter is the agency's advisory action that alerts a retailer and provides notice that the establishment is not in compliance with federal laws and/or regulations regarding the sale and distribution of regulated tobacco products. A CMP is a monetary sum assessed for violations of the law. CMP complaints are issued against retailers who have received a warning letter for violations of federal tobacco laws and regulations, but continue to have violations. An NTSO is an order prohibiting the sale of tobacco products at a retail establishment. NTSO complaints are issued against retailers who have repeated violations of certain tobacco restrictions and who have already received multiple CMPs. A complaint is the legal document that identifies the statutory or regulatory violations that are the basis for seeking a CMP or NTSO. A retailer who has received a CMP or NTSO complaint has four options. Option 1. They can acknowledge that the violations occurred and, in the case of a CMP, pay the full penalty amount, or, in the case of an NTSO, reach out to CTP to agree on the dates when the NTSO will take place. Option 2. Settlement. A retailer can discuss a possible settlement of their CMP or NTSO if their case has specific facts or circumstances that they believe should reduce the CMP amount or NTSO period. These are called mitigating factors. CTP may consider mitigating factors to determine if it is appropriate to settle a case for a lower CMP amount or a reduction in the NTSO period. Option 3. Request a hearing. A retailer who wishes to contest the case may submit an answer to the Departmental Appeals Board and request a hearing. Option 4. Request an extension of time to file an answer. A retailer who needs more than 30 days to file an answer must request an extension from the Departmental Appeals Board. If you have difficulty effectively communicating in English, there are multiple types of assistance available. If you are looking to acknowledge the violations or resolve your case through a settlement, CTP may be able to provide you with language assistance services with option 1 or 2 for responding to your complaint. If you are looking to contest your case and exercise option 3 or 4, the Departmental Appeals Board provides free language assistance services. If you wish to resolve your CMP or NTSO case without a hearing, but English is not your primary language, CTP can provide language assistance services. CTP typically provides language assistance by making an interpreter available who speaks your language and who can help you communicate with a representative from CTP during a phone call. If you need assistance in a language other than English, please reach out to the Center for Tobacco Products by calling 877-287-1373 or emailing the Center for Tobacco Products at ctp-cmp@fda.hhs.gov. If you wish to contest your CMP or NTSO and want a hearing, but English is not your primary language, the Departmental Appeals Board provides language services. If you need assistance in a language other than English, please reach out to the Departmental Appeals Board at 202-565-0200 or send an email to DAB Administration Division at hhs.gov. When you contact CTP, please provide your name, the languages other than English that you prefer to speak, a phone number where you can be contacted, and the docket numbers for your case. You can find these numbers on the cover letter that accompanied the complaint for your case. In order to ensure that CTP can provide you with the appropriate interpreter, you will also need to provide when you will be available within the next 2 to 5 days to discuss your case with CTP and the interpreter. After securing an interpreter, CTP will attempt to contact you to confirm the date and time of your phone call with a CTP representative and an interpreter. It is important to be prepared to discuss your case. Please make a note of the dates and times that you said you would be available. Please have your CMP or NTSO complaint available during these times and prepare a list of questions for CTP or points you would like to raise if you plan to discuss the settlement of your case. If you are not going to be available during one of the times that you told CTP, please contact CTP. If you have additional questions regarding how to request language assistance, please direct any questions to us via email at ctp-cmp@fda.hhs.gov or via phone at 877-287-1373. Thank you for watching this presentation brought to you by FDA's Center for Tobacco Products, whose mission is to protect our youth and the nation's health from the dangers of tobacco.